Hey everybody, it's Bill from MattTracker.com and welcome to this episode of Behind the Mask. Lately I've been deviating from mask just because, well, DC has forced my hand with a lot of things that they were doing, but this episode that I have, that I'm talking about right now, I've been working on off and on for a little while, and that revolves around the Marvel Secret Wars line. Secret Wars, if you're not familiar, it was a comic, which have up here. So I got some comics here, so you can see. That actually is the first appearance of the Black Suit Spider-Man. And what you have with this line, it's unique because of the way that they kind of work together with the superpowers line, but not really. And we'll talk about that in a second. So, if you had these when you were younger, you probably had the main wave of Captain America, Wolverine, Spider-Man, Iron Man. That's probably what you had in your wheelhouse, and there's no faulting you for that, because that's what was readily available. The problem with these was that the line really got cut short, and it didn't really show a lot of the characters that were in the comic book. And it was a missed opportunity because there were pretty much almost every comic book character in there. There's a ton of costumes out there that really look like they could fit right into the line. But I do have the entire set right here, and we'll go over them briefly. I don't have all the accessories. They're weird accessories. Everybody has a shield with a hologram. Somebody has guns. Like, Iron Man has a gun. Why does he need a gun? I don't know. And one thing I really want to try to accomplish, and if you know how to do this, is I want my Captain America to actually have a Captain America shield. So I know there's some figures that are this kind of height that could work where you could hold it, but I don't know the exact line. And I'm hoping to find that so I can, you know, just for display purposes. But as, like I said, I do have the entire line of the Secret Wars figures themselves, just missing the accessories. So before I go into the figures, though, for some reason, and I don't even know why I have it. So I have the Tower of Doom, and I have the box. Don't know why. I don't even know how. Actually, you know what? No. You know, this here. Yeah. Columbus, New Jersey is a flea market. And I think this was probably my best flea market find. I bought the Temple of Doom, and I have it over here. It's not complete, mind you. It's missing this arm thing here where you kind of swivel off. $3. And there were other accessories with it too. But it's cool to have the actual box to it. And I have this on display. The problem with the display of this inside of the IKEA cases is that you can't really put this in there. So I'm missing a gun here too, but kind of see it for what it is. Got it close by. It's got an elevator, goes up and down. Doesn't have as much to do as Hall of Justice, but it's definitely, it's a cool piece to help display the figures. Got a little like jail cell thing here in the front. You kind of see it here in the back. And again, this is where that arm would be if I had it. And then you have a spot up here where you can set a gunner and a, you know, stop the bad guys from coming in. So it's a cool piece. I have it on display in my collection behind me here, which it's going to be empty for the time being, because that's where it goes, because I'm talking about it. So, I'll fix the camera. So we have, here's Batman, who's not part of this line, but these figures, because of their scaling, these figures, because of their scaling, you could have DC and Marvel together when you were a kid. They didn't have the same actions. They're all, you know, the articulation is like 5 points. You can turn the head, arms, and legs. That was all you had. Superpowers, you had a couple more. You can bend the legs at the knee. And that kind of, and you also have the powers of them punching or doing whatever they're doing. So, but the line itself, I was always fascinated with it because the characters that they chose. You have your classics. Captain America, right? Spider-Man. Wolverine, who also has black claws. So if you find that in the wild, it's worth a lot of money. Black Claw Wolverine, right? Iron Man. Here. You got Iron Man. And then from there, it kind of gets a little weird with its character selection, as I said earlier. The villains that they picked, hit or miss, I would say. It's cool to see Kang as a villain, but it still leaves a lot to be desired. And you'll notice that a lot of these body molds are pretty similar. Not all of them are, though. So some of them do have unique features to them, and we'll see that in a minute. But the main villains are Dr. Doom. You have Magneto. Who has a gun. I don't know. Kang the Conqueror here. Right? And then Dr. Octopus. By the way, this figure is hard to find intact. The arms on him are incredibly brittle, where they meet on the abdomen and the ribcage. And it took me a long time to find one that wasn't broken. So like a long time, I just had some weird looking guy who looked like this with no arms, and I didn't know who it was. I know who it was, but you get the point. So that's like the crux of the line. And then you kind of get some of these other characters going on too. So there was a foreign release, and we'll get to that in a minute. But then you had some of these other characters here. And I want to make sure that I'm in the right realm. Because you had Series 1, which we went over. Right? And then we got Series 2. Yeah, Series 2 is where it gets a little bit odd. So we have Baron Zemo, which out of all the characters that Marvel has at its disposal for a figure line, why would you pick Baron Zemo? Where's the Red Skull? Where's anybody for that matter? And then you have the Hobgoblin. I don't have his glider, but he comes with a glider. A lot of the ones that I've come across have really weak leg joints, and I don't know if that is the way the manufacturer put it together or if that was just a design flaw in general, but for the most part, not too bad. And then the heroes of this line of Series 2 are Black Suit Spider-Man, which you saw the comic. A lot of them are, you know, hard to stand, especially the original Spider, like the original Spider-Man costume and this one. These figures are hard to stand on their own. I usually had this one propped up in the back. You have Falcon, who also comes with a Falcon. Oh, his wings are backwards. There we go. So you got Falcon. And Daredevil. Mine is very discolored. I'm pretty sure he's supposed to have a, you know, a human face, but this is the one I have. So you got Daredevil. And then you get into the figures that are just hard to find in general. So these are classified as foreign release. And I'll start with one of the figures that I always just found weird. Like, and again, like I said, with Baron Zemo, why would you pick that character when you have so many others? My Constrictor is not in the greatest condition because it's hard to find in really good condition. And it's also worth a lot of money, too. So here's Constrictor. No accessories, but you have like a whip, like a snake whip, I think it was. And then we get into the meat and potatoes here. One of these is actually my favorite Marvel character behind Captain America, and we'll get to him in a second. So we have Electro. Very hard to come by. I don't like moving him around too much. I'm afraid that I'll break him. And let's see if we can see the back here. And just to get an idea of what it says there. This says, I think it says France on it. Yeah, it's hard to see. But Electro is a character. You can see the head sculpt is different than any of the other ones that we have. Hard to find in this condition too. I've seen others that are banged up worse than this go for $200 or more loose. I got lucky on mine. And then we have my favorite character behind Captain America in the Marvel Universe, and that's Iceman. Iceman, again, hard to find in good condition, really tight joints. It's hard to find paint flaws with him because, he's just ice. But the likelihood that you're going to find one of these in really good condition is hard to come by. It's probably about $200 loose as well, just like Electro. But it's just like a weird dynamic because you have the kind of spattering of the characters they have here, and there's just, well, one, there's no female characters. That's one thing to point out. So maybe Mattel called Kenner and said, "Hey, how do we keep the women characters down here?" That's it is something glaring. I mean, superpowers line, I only had one. It was Wonder Woman. So I can't say that they did any better, but they did technically. The Secret Wars line, because of the scaling with the superpowers line, it was one that I held fondly in my memory to this day. Mask was always my first, Batman close second. So whenever I had Batman here, and because I had all these characters and the scaling, this was easy to correlate, and it stuck with me. And the secret powers, yeah, the secret powers here, secret powers. I just combined it together, secret powers. Secret Wars line, because I played with them so much when I was a kid, it stuck. And I didn't have all these other characters. When I was a kid, I had Captain America, Wolverine, Spider-Man, and like Iron Man, and maybe Dr. Octopus. Like recollecting with Mask, superpowers, and almost anything else, there's so many things that you find out about that you didn't have, that you didn't know existed, that you wanna try to preserve. And my room is dedicated to Mask, but as you can see behind me, there's other things that I want to, try to preserve too. And the Secret Wars line is one of those elements. I will always have a soft spot for it in my heart, and it'll always be in my collection, even if I, kind of wind it down. It's always going to be there. Same thing with superpowers, and same thing with Mask. But what was your kind of recollection of the Secret Wars line? Was it Did you like it more than superpowers? Did you kind of recollect it as you got older? Do you still have any from when you were a kid? Are they beat up like some of mine were? I had to replace a lot of mine. The paint wear kind of took its toll. But if you have any questions about it, my, Tower of Doom there. If you have any questions about the figures, please feel free to ask. Again, It's not MASH channel, but sometimes I like to deviate, and lately I've been deviating a lot. And that's just because there's so much more out there outside of MASH, but that doesn't mean that I'm not still here keeping MASH alive, because that is the mantra of the website, the channel, and everything that I'm doing. So thank you for watching, and please remember to like, comment, and subscribe to help keep MASH alive. And until next time, this is Bill from MattTracker.com, and I'll talk to you later.